Welcome to my new Let's Play Fallout 3 series. Well, the audio is really overpowering. Yeah. Okay, so now this is gonna be a Let's roleplay Fallout 3. Difficulty normal. Sure, yeah. I'll keep it at normal level. Okay, let us begin a new game.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of.
War. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything, from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters. No one ever enters.
Time to be born.
Are you a boy or a girl?
We are a boy.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little girl. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about it?
Well, this gentleman here is James Cole, our father. The woman beside her is Catherine Cole, our mother, and we are... Albert Cole.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Yep. Caucasian. Yeah, this one. Perfect. Yes.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're James? Just a...
Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on.
Okay.
The doctor, not a dead man. Failed to meet my expectations.
Don't look straight into the light.
James and his cheery
feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on.
Daddy.
There you go. My goodness. Just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. Be back in a bit.
The look of disappointment and the feeling of betrayal fills our little head. After realizing that we have just been tricked into this cage over here. That makes us very angry. So we want to toss the ball, but I guess we're not a very strong boy. There you go. Oh, would you look at that? Dad forgot to lock the gate. Haha. Another thorn. Bear. Tickle, tickle, tickle. Okay, Mr. Bear. Tell me again about the little girl who slept in your bed and ate your porridge and who broke into your home. I think we may have a case against her. Yeah. Don't worry, we will win this one. Okay, playtime over. Time to read. Right. So, you're special. This is for strength, and that means I'm strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. Okay, let's suppose we are average in strength, so 5. Piece of perception, a long funny word. It means what I tasted, smelled, saw, and heard. Ah, yeah, we are. So it's slightly above average, so 6. E is for endurance. That's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. Well, slightly below average, so 4. C is for charisma. It's why people think I'm great. I make my friends all laugh and smile and never want to hate. And our charisma will be 9, so really high. I is for intelligence. It means I'm really smart. I use my brain for lots of stuff, like science, math, and art. Yeah, slightly above average, so 6. A is for agility. That's how I get around. I move real fast and easy, and I never make a sound. Slightly below average, so 4. L is for luck, and it's simple, you see. It means that good things always happen to me. And a little bit higher than average, so 6. Right, let's review our special stats. And I think we're done here. Okay, let's go to bed. Can we play with the rockets? No.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amato wants to play.
Okay, Dad, I'm coming. Where are we going?
Experiments prepared. Surprise.
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday.
Aw, thanks.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well... you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibilities. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000.
Ooh, cool.
Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun. Having a good time? It wasn't easy keeping this a secret. Go on.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
Hey, great party, Amata. Thanks for doing this for me.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff. Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
How about a date with Christina Kendall?
Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than me and Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
I'm sure everyone else would like a chance to talk to the birthday boy.
Are you having a nice time?
Enjoy yourself.
Hey, Officer Gomez.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Thanks.
I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Well, of course she likes me. I'm a really charming guy. Charisma 9.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Enjoy. Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
Oh, Mrs. Palmer, you didn't have to bring me a present.
Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go, a nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Thanks. Looks delicious. I want a hat too. Let's put on a party hat. Andy, what did you do? Aw, you ruined the cake.
How's it going, pal? Happy birthday. I would offer you a piece of cake, but...
Yeah, it's okay.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
Oh, Butch. Well, yes, you do look hungry. What? Your mom drank up all the ration coupons again?
Don't you talk about my mom, you little punk!
Told you not gonna be sorry, you little official. I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
First, you have to catch him, Butch.
Butch,
what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone!
Besides, that friend of yours could use a reminder.
You all right, son? Not all. He didn't hurt you, did he? I hope Butch didn't hurt you. You want to tell me what that was all about?
Gomez, that it was nothing. Just boys being boys.
That's fine, son. I'm glad to see you're not letting Butch bully you. He's gonna be a handful in a few years if his mother doesn't take him in hand. Well, no harm done, then. Why don't you get back to enjoying your party?
Yeah.
This is supposed to be a party,
you're gonna be
you
really
know?
Sorry you messed with me, Paul.
You should try sometime, Daddy.
Man, you got a pit boy. I wish I was 10.
Aw, Butch, did I hurt your feelings?
Anyway, I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk.
Well, you know, Marta, your dad's the overseer. Can't you talk to him about Butch?
Come on, don't ask me that. You know he would if I asked, but where would that leave me? It's bad enough being the overseer's daughter. If everyone knew I ran to Daddy every time I had a problem, nobody would ever talk to me again. We'll think of some way to get Butch back, I promise. But I'm not getting my father involved.
Nice pit boy. What is that? This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Do you think we surprised him?
So, Ollie, where's your pit boy?
Hey, how about
oh, looks like you didn't get one.
Thanks for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier.
I think you really are.
It's fine, I hope.
How do you like that pit boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
Oh yeah, it's perfect. It's really cool. Did you fix it up for me?
As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Yeah, me too. Thanks, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
How's it going, pal?
Come on, Wally. You always have...
Oh, cool. We got a baseball hat. Yeah, let's put on a hat.
Good ideas.
Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again?
Ah, don't worry, Dad. I can handle Butch.
I'm glad to hear it. Once you start letting bullies push you around, you'll never see the end of it. Come on now. I bet there's someone else out there with a present for you.
How are
you doing the party, Mrs. Palmer? The Mac.
I helped with the decorations.
Super cool, right?
Jeez, Wally, who's that in the gang? You or me?
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
Hello, Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could meet
Paul.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important to keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job.
Another youth, well on his way to becoming a productive vault citizen.
Happy birthday.
Thanks. Happy birthday,
son. Send him right down.
Thanks.
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
What kind of surprise? Okay.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party.
Not yet. It's still going on. Yeah, my dad and Amata threw me a great party, didn't they?
They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem. Just for you. I hope you like it.
Oh, thank you. I will treasure it always. Is that all?
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Okay, let's read the poem. Data, notes, birthday bomb, poem. Gray walls, impenetrable steel, suffocation, condemnation, little hands groping in a subterranean uncertainty. Mommy? Daddy? Am I dead? Nay, nay, reborn into purifying fluorescence. A face emerges, strong and male. Father to me, father to all. Overseeing our lives, our eternities, harshness of discipline, harshness of love, obedience, my savior. Larva to pupa, pupa to worker, buzz buzz. One with the steel honeycomb, 10 lies within the 101. Significant at last, till gray seeps from walls, to hair, to soul. Then, eternal slumber, the sweet, sweet sleep of incineration. Yes, very uplifting poem. Okay, reactor level that way. Downstairs. Let's not dally. Let's go and find out what the surprise is. Oh, hi, Jonas.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
But my dad told me it was okay to come down here.
Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
What surprise?
Your dad is waiting to give you your present. Or should we just keep it?
Are you ready for your surprise?
What kind of surprise?
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work. So, I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Butch is carrying a switchblade? Here? I mean, surely we can't shoot here.
We sure can't, unless we want the overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on. Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
Oh, this is great. Thanks, Dad.
Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Thanks, Jonas. Aim carefully. Yeah, 3 out of 3. Trying to hit the head. There you go. Dead.
Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas.
Yeah, that's a great idea.
The big game hunter.
Smile.
I'm the overseer's daughter, so what?
That
like,
is
I
not
get any kind of special.
Tell me.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha, beginning, and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take.
Is there anything I need to know about the goat?
The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. GOAT. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar?
Well, I mean, is it true that was everyone born in the vault?
That's what the overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here.
Do we really have to die in the vault? Can't we ever leave?
That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have, because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either.
Can we talk about, you know, Mom?
Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life. About love. But most of all, she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner.
Okay, yeah, I guess I have a goat to take, so bye, Dad.
Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
Yeah. pick up the bobblehead. Hey, good Jones. Day.
Stopped. Hey, 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 sport. It's been a while since you stopped in here to see us.
It sure has.
Goat day today, right?
Mm-hmm. That's right. Get out of my way, but I'm not worried. I'm sure I will ace it.
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amata.
God, Butch, why don't you just leave me alone?
What are you gonna do, Amata?
Go run and tell your daddy on. What's the matter? Yeah? What do you want?
Hey, what's going on here?
None of your business, kid. Get out of here before you get hurt. If you mess with the tunnel snakes, you're asking for it. Got me?
Butch, if you keep messing with her, the overseer is going to come down on your gang.
Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time.
Yeah, yeah. Just get out of here.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Yeah. Let's go. Butch has always been an idiot.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat?
Mm-hmm.
Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Sure, I'm ready. I bet I'll ace it.
I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. You don't want to be the first class in history to fail the goat, do you?
Okay.
Well, has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Blotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
Yeah, up yours too, buddy.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor has stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Scream for help.
Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
Ah, poor little thing. I'll just give him a hug and tell him everything will be a-okay.
Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Actually, I prefer soccer.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do?
I suppose you should always respect your elders and, you know, so I'll take the gun.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
I'll trade a vault hoodlum for his cherry bomb and just blow the door open.
Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
A lead injection straight to the head.
Question eight. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book. Issue number one. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it?
Well, barter for it.
Question nine. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and...
I'll mess up with his medicine cabinet.
Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person involved 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
My father. But this obviously doesn't give us too much of a choice now, does it? So.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Good to see you.
Get out of my face.
Hey, Butch, I'm first. Not you.
All finished? Wow. It says here you're going to be the vault's marriage counselor. Almost makes me want to get married, just to be able to avail myself of your services.
Wow. That's what I always wanted to be. My dreams are finally coming true.
Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Barter small guns and speech. Perfect. Okay.
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks. Hello.
Guess that means she's going to be the next overseer. What did you get, Butch?
We'll talk to your little friend later.
Oh?
Hey.
Butch, did you fail the exam? Is that why you left without even hearing the results?
I'll see you tomorrow. Anything is possible, even an A.
Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on, you've got to wake up!
Huh? Amata, what's wrong?
You've got to get out of here. Your dad is gone and my father's men are looking for you.
Hey, what do you mean, my dad is gone?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
Amata, I've never seen you so scared. What happened?
It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men. They took him and... Oh my god, you have to leave now!
Oh jeez. Oh my god, are you okay?
Yeah, don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas was your friend. But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute.
Wait. My dad can't have left. The door is sealed shut.
Not anymore, apparently. But are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you?
No. I had no idea he was planning to leave.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you? But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
Okay, how?
Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in.
Okay, I guess that's a good plan. Come on, let's get out of here.
Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Okay, thanks, Amata. Hey, look, listen, I promise you, I will only use it as a last resort.
Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck!
Okay.
I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
Just grab my stuff. Okay. And, Yeah, let's grab a baseball bat.
There he is, right there.
Well,
crime any more roaches.
Okay, well, he's being distracted by the rat roaches.
You gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches!
Oh, Butch, asking me for help. If only you had the brain power to realize or understand what irony means.
Yeah, I'm asking you. So what? Look, I'm sorry for the way I've always treated you. You know I never meant any of it, right? But it's my mom. You can't leave her in there with the rad roaches.
I mean, why do you need my help anyway? Are you honestly afraid of few rad roaches?
Well, yeah, so I hate rad roaches. So what? I tried to go back in to help her. I swear I did. But I just can't do it. So I'm begging you, please help her. I don't know what I'd do without my mom.
Hey, Butch, you're big, they're little. Just go back in there and squish them. Be a hero.
You know what? You're right. They aren't anything I can't handle. Tunnel snakes rule!
Yeah, that's the attitude.
We did it! My mom's gonna be okay! You're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my tunnel snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Yeah, grab some. Okay, great. Oh, this is my room. It's gone now. Where do I have to go? Guess here. Yeah. Rat roaches, huh? Okay. Yeah, I think upstairs. Roaches inside his wall. Take that. Damn, it's more roaches.
Yeah, yeah. Oh, you're lucky it was me who found you. The others won't be so forgiving. I don't know what you're up to, and I don't want to know. Just clear out of here, and I'll pretend I never saw you.
Right, thanks, Gomez. And I'll pretend that you don't work for a homicidal maniac.
Don't think I don't know it. Why do you think I'm letting you go? I guess you're trying to follow your dad. Outside. Good gravy, if I didn't know what the Overseer would do if he caught you, I'd never tell you to try for it, but it's your only shot. You take care, and I hope you find your daddy.
It's a classroom.
You're the one everybody's looking for, right? Me and Andy were in a tight spot.
Any supplies in here? Just a quick check. There probably isn't anything. Yeah, okay. Okay, I don't know. I think the clinic doesn't really have any supplies at the moment.
Go back to our quarters.
It's our only chance. Don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Oh.
Oh, the maniacs just killing everyone.
You! This is your fault. You and your stupid father. He had to go and leave, didn't he? He had to miss for everybody.
Hey, happy horse. Wrench, conductor, and sensor module. I'll take those.
I told
you. Well, guess I'll take the wrench as well.
Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend. I was worried about him.
Mm-hmm.
What does he have to do with
your father? Be so
probably nothing. Why, you need to tell us. So I can talk to you.
Do what your dad says, Amata.
Please, Daddy.
All right, officer. Trust him.
No!
Amata, please, don't be stubborn. I only want to talk to your friend.
I knew.
Hey, leave her alone.
You turn up sooner or later.
Well. Yeah. Screw you. Yeah.
Guards!
I hope you're here to turn yourself in, young man. You're already in enough trouble as it is. Don't make it worse for yourself.
If you ever had, if you ever lay a hand on Amata again, I'll make you regret it.
I place the good of the vault above everything, even my own paternal feelings. We must not allow sentiment to cloud our judgment. But I admire your protective instincts. Very well. I give you my word that Amata will not suffer further because of your actions. Now then, if you really care about Amata, you will see how dangerous your father's actions were. Hand over your weapons, and put an end to this dangerous situation. There is no need to join your father as a traitor to the vault.
Is that what you said to Jonas before you killed him? Oh, time to die, old man. My father's no traitor, but you're a murderer, thug.
Let's let history be the judge of that. If you had paid attention to Mr. Brotch, you'd understand that history is invariably written by the victor.
And I intend to be the victor. You won't survive the night. Guards, help me!
Yeah.
I always knew it would come to this.
How dare you threaten me?
Okay, let's not shoot him. Let's not kill the overseer. Well, if you don't have to. I was actually just trying to cripple his legs so he wouldn't be able to like follow me, but
you. I told you my father wasn't himself. I don't know what he might have done if you hadn't come along. You'd better get out of here. I'll try to meet you at the vault door. If I don't make it, good luck.
Oh, you know what? I think I accidentally took like the key to that. Amato.
Thank
you. Okay, let's just skip that. I'll take the ammo. Right. Well, so I can pick this. Get a little XP. Ammo, mentats, stim pack. Let's hack this. Okay, well, tries 2 out of 5 suits, 3 out of 5. Oh, can't be traps. Can't be kinds. Okay, that's 2, and that's 3. Yep. Okay, security dossier, tunnel snakes. If Butch and his leather-clad delinquents accost Amata one more time, they'll have more to deal with than their acerbic teacher. Their services have come in handy upon occasion, but they're starting to become unruly. If dogs become feral, they must be put down. I'll have to remind Butch of that upon our next meeting. Beatrice, just what World 101 needs, an absent-minded, sexually repressed psychophant. Beatrice has served World 101 admirably for years, but her mind is growing feeble. I'll have to speak with our good doctor about some kind of long-term pharmaceutical solution. We may at least be able to keep her comfortable and quiet until she passes on. Jonas. I never should have assigned Jonas as James' assistant. He was always too idealistic for his own good. Now he spends every waking minute with the good doctor, who gleefully fills his ears with even more idealistic nonsense. I've considered reassigning him, but the truth is, Jonas is a fine medic in his own right, and hiding him down in the maintenance would be a terrible waste of resources. Amata. Every time I try to get Amata to open up, she just pushes me further and further away. Since she was a child, I've tried to instill in her those virtues that have made this vault what it is today. Loyalty, honesty, commitment, hard work. She does try, and with a lot of guidance, has grown into a fine young woman. That makes it all the sadder that she continues to alienate me. She looks at me and sees the overseer, not the father that has cared for her alone. Alone since she was an infant. Scouting reports. Report 2241-0210. As our tests suggested, the immediate vicinity of the vault is no longer dangerously irradiated, although the background radiation is still well above safe levels. Pockets of more intense radiation appear to still be common, and all surface water seems to be undrinkable. We will need to carry ample supplies of Radex with us on all future surveys, but hazard suits do not seem to be necessary for general exploration. Our old maps are largely useless. The town of Springvale is an abandoned ruin, and all pre-war roads have disappeared or are no longer passable. We encountered a group of monstrous ants which appear to confirm Mackie's theories of mutation due to extended exposure to radiation. We drove off the ants with gunfire and collected several specimens for study upon return to the vault. See Exhibit A. The good news is that human civilization still survives, despite everything. We discovered a settlement known as, quote, Megaton, unquote. See Exhibit B, whose inhabitants, although somewhat varied at first, soon welcomed us into their town. We spent a good deal of time in Megaton and learned a great deal about the, quote, capital wasteland, unquote, as the area around Washington, D.C. is now called. From them, Megaton is a fortified outpost of civilization, of sorts, but it seems that giant ants are the least of the dangers of this new world. We agreed that it was prudent to return to the vault immediately to revise our survey plans in light of what we have learned. Louis and Agnes remain in Megaton to serve as ambassadors and continue to collect information until we return. Ann Palmer, Survey Team Leader, February 10th, 2241. Exhibit A, it's a picture of an ant. Exhibit B, the entrance to Megaton. Vault-Tec instructions. Oof, there's a lot to read. Letter from Dr. Stanislav Braun. A letter to the overseer from Dr. Stanislav Braun. If you are reading this, emergency vault internment procedures have been initiated, and you and your control group have been sealed into your vault. Congratulations. You are now a vital part of the most ambitious program ever undertaken by Vault-Tec. If you have not yet read your sealed orders, do so now. They will outline the experimental protocols assigned to your control group. Please remember that deviation from these protocols in any way will jeopardize the success of the program and may be considered grounds for termination by Vault-Tec Corporation, as outlined in your employment agreement. Your vault may or may not have been selected to receive a GEC module. Please see Attachment A for details. Dr. Stanislav Braun, Director, Societal Preservation Program, Vault-Tec Corporation. Attachment A. Vault 101 will not receive a GEC module and should operate under the guidelines laid forth in the Overseer's sealed orders. Vault-Tec scientific entry, the GEC. The Geek is quite simply the most advanced piece of technology ever developed by Vault-Tec. A terraforming module capability of capable of creating life from complete lifelessness. After riding out the storm of nuclear Armageddon in a Vault-Tec patented vault, residents can then activate the Geek and create a new earthen paradise. Craters and dust will give away to rolling grasslands and sparkling clear water. Of course, due to time and monetary constraints, not every vault will be equipped with a Geek module. Okay. And open the tunnel. Oh, by the way, I should probably, yeah, because we have a security armor, so we might as well, wear it. Do I even have a helmet for that? Yeah, we do. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, let's just shoot them. We got plenty of rounds now. Activate the switch. Open the little secret door. And this is the entrance. Okay, let's open.
You did it! You opened the door! My God, I almost didn't believe it was possible.
Yeah, well, Amata, I could not have done it without your help.
No, you didn't need me. If anyone can survive out there, it's you.
Well, why don't you come with me?
It's tempting, but my place is here. The vault needs me more than you do. I'm the only one who has a chance to talk some sense into my father. Listen, if you do catch up with your dad, tell him I'm sorry for... for, you know, Jonas and my father and everything. Goodbye.
Yeah, goodbye, Mata. Well. Okay, if you want to be killed, then no problem. Okay, time to leave this place. Looks like they're closing the door behind me. Right. Okay. Open the door to the capital wasteland. Ooh, that was loud. Yeah, we could revise our character if we wanted, but it's for me. Let us step into the open wasteland. Oh, it's bright. A world scorched by nuclear fire. And a level up. Okay, let's see. Couple more points to barter and speech. What else? Well, I think small guns is good. Medicine has been useful. You know what? Lockpick to. Oh, actually, 23 will be enough. Because then with a hat. Wait a second. Don't I have like a. Oh, you know what? 20 is enough. I have like a utility jumpsuit, so Yeah, okay. What else? What else? Maybe I'll pump the rest into like repair. Sure. A little bit sneak. Maybe this is fine. Round off, maybe big guns. Okay. Alright, gun nut, small guns, and small guns and repair. Maybe. Yeah, I think these are useful skills. Useful skills to for survival, so yeah, okay, I'll take the gun nut. One first rank of the gun nut perk. Right. Let's make a save here. Okay, so I think this has gone far too long enough. I mean, this introduction section is just, yeah, it's long. The whole tutorial mission, the introduction, its character creation, it's setting up the backstory. It's a lot of stuff. Bethesda sure crammed a lot of stuff at this very first portion of the game. And of course the introduction video and everything. And the narration by Ron Perlman and etc. Okay, thank you for watching, and when we return we shall explore, we shall begin our exploration of the Capital Wasteland, and of course we already know that there's a settlement nearby called Megaton, so I'm sure we'll also pay a visit to there as well. Okay, goodbye.